हाय मालिका, we'll wait for a few people to join in. हाय फ्रैंक एसबी, कृतिका सिंह, वेलकम टू अ लाइव. आई थिंक वी जस्ट नीड अ फ्यू मोर मिनट्स फर्स्ट पीपल टू जॉइन इन. ओके कृतिका, व्हाई डोंट यू डीएम अस एंड वील गेट बैक टू यू रिगार्डिंग इट. ओके, इज दैट ओके विद यू? या जस्ट लाइक a little bit more time and then we'll get started with our guest and yeah, we'll talk about today's topic. Welcome everyone whosoever joined by now, and yeah, as you all know that we will be having a guest today, and she's gonna join us in a little bit of time. Meanwhile, we'll just talk about a little, you know, what's the topic today. As you must have read the topic, it says, you know, quality time with children, how to spend quality time with children and how to manage stress for those people who are working and have little ones at home and maybe even the elder ones. We all need guidance today or tomorrow, someday of, you know, sometime there are certain moments when we feel that, we can't do it anymore. So, yeah, and right. Fear request. Am I supposed to add? So, as you must have seen the flyers and the posts and everything, that today there is a very special guest who will be there, and so I think our very special guest is here, and I've already added, so let's see how long it's going to take. Hello.
Hello, hi, good evening.
Hi, good evening, Dr. Mona. How are you?
Very well, Harshita. How are you doing?
Oh, I am doing great, and we all are very delighted to have you here with us. For
Thank you
sharing
so
your
much. Thank you.
experience and your knowledge and your learnings and every work you've done by now.
Thank you. Thank you so
So,
much. Yes,
before
I'm excited to, yes, be a part of this
I think
wonderful,
there's a little
gathering.
problem with I think there's a little problem with your network, because you were very blurred here. So
Okay,
if
just give me a minute.
yeah. So meanwhile, Dr. Mona is fixing
Better?
her camera, and yeah, better
Better?
network. I would like to introduce her as a writer, an author to a book, as I told you earlier, Raising a Mindful Parent. Now, as I was telling everyone here with us who has joined, that raising a mindful parent is an amazing topic, a concept which is You know, like I was telling them that we are very excited to know that how children grow, right? How they we are raising them, but we never get to know that we are raising ourselves as a parent.
Right.
And
right.
I mean, reading a topic like that, I would love to read that book. I'm so sorry I haven't read it by now, but definitely I'm going to read it.
No problem. Please order it soon. And for everyone who's watching, it is available on Amazon. You can order it directly on Amazon, and that's there behind me. You can see that book there. So probably, yeah.
Yeah, we can. It's kept there. So,
right.
Your voice is cracking, Dr. Mona.
Okay.
Your voice is cracking, yeah.
Okay, let me put the, you know, the wired.
So I have a lot of your introduction with me. That is like, you know, you have n number of achievements with inside your own book, your own diary. It's amazing. I mean, reading so much and then, you know, trying to keep in mind, I'm like, jot down everything that she has this, she has that, she has this, she has that.
You're being
I'm
so like, kind. Thank you so
I'm
much.
Not,
you're being so kind.
Trust me, I'm not. I was like, I'm so not used to writing anymore because, you know, everything has become online and on typing. Mm. So when I was writing, I was like, yeah, she has done this. Now she has done this. Now she has done this. Now that's wonderful. So let me just quickly tell everyone what all you have done. So, okay, you are a dental surgeon. Now, that's what your doctor is for. And like, how is your journey from dental surgeon to a parenting coach? How did that happen?
You know, this is what was meant to happen. And this is where the universe was preparing me for all this. So I am by education. I always wanted to be a doctor. And somehow this thing, you know, fascinated me. So I went into dentistry. And I was doing very well. And after my children came in, basically, so I did not have any help around.
Okay.
So this is what the thing was. I was never in a favor of leaving my children with, you know, in someone else's care. I mean, because my parents or my in-laws were not there. So I did not want to leave them with a crutch or some, you know, a help at home and while I am out. So that is the time when I started to take a step back from my career. And, you know, concentrate on my children at that time, because that is the time when they needed the most. Yeah. And incidentally, you know, when I was doing my dentistry, so I had a big plan of opening a dental clinic for children, only for children, where only children will be treated. So I done my diploma in child psychology during the time I was expecting my first daughter.
Okay.
So that, you know, laid the foundation of what I'm doing now. I never knew that. But then, you know, the universe has bigger plans for me.
Right.
So this is what happened. And but every time, you know, I try to go back after my children were like little grown up. I tried to go back, but this was not happening. Then it happened on the journey as my children were going. They faced, you know, issues. And they were having problems. And this is where my knowledge and my, you know, experience came into being. I started handling my children and seeing that because, you know, the friends around, the everybody around, my children's friends, their parents seeing how I was handling them. They started asking me, you know, for tips and a little bit ideas and about how to raise a child, how to do this, how to do that.
Right.
And on the way, I, you know, I found that everybody is dealing with a lot of, you know, a lot of all the parents are feeling stuck somewhere with on the journey of parenting. So that inspired me to write a book that, you know, why not I write a book so that it will reach the masses. It will, you know, help whoever needs it. That was the idea and intention behind it. And I wrote the book. And after I wrote the book, somehow, you know, it increased. The queries started increasing and then I came full time. You know, I started counseling and then the whole thing started for me from there. So, yeah, from that time, I've been doing that.
That's
a beautiful journey.
That's actually a wonderful journey.
Yes, yes. Beautiful journey. Yes.
So that means your kids are reflecting all of your efforts pretty well that everyone needs and wants to learn.
Yes, I keep my fingers crossed because yes, it is. It is a difficult journey with children.
It's. So, I suppose it's a great journey for them to have a mother like you. Trust me. And now you have a recent star on your shoulder that says that you've been awarded with Power Woman Award in 2021.
Yes,
Now, would
yes,
you like to share
yeah.
with us how did that happen, and you know, how did you deal with like
So this
being,
is
you know, so useful to people around?
So this is basically, I would say, technology has a big role to play into this because, since the lockdown, everything has been online. And people around, not only in my area, I stay in Gurgaon, so not only in Gurgaon, but people in other places have also started, acknowledging, and it is by the word of mouth that, the technology, social media is helping a lot. So that is when I think people who are following me recommended me, to someone, the organizers of the award. So this is how it all happened. So it has been all like technology has to play a big part in
That
this.
is actually wonderful because you know like the people who do not know that you know your contribution towards the field of
Yes.
parenting by the Lead India Foundation that was
Yes.
founded by late
Founded
President Shri Abdul Kalam ji,
Abdul
and
Kalam ji. Yes.
so anyone who did not know about it now knows that she is the lady to approach now regarding any
Yeah.
parenting advice you
Right.
need tomorrow. So that brings us
Yes.
to our topic
Great.
today, which says that quality time with children are now. There are many things, how to spend it, what to do, what not to do, you know, many things. So let's start. Why quality time over quantity time? Like people are like, I
Right.
spend, 10 hours a day with my child and I stay 24 hours with my child. Now that's more important. So why do you think that
Right.
quality time is more important over any day? Quantity time.
So a very good question, quality time over quantity time. So quantity time is, we do not in anything that you are doing in life, we always look for the quality in that, not the quantity, right? If as we can have, we always look for that, the quality over the quantity. Same thing applies to our dealings with the children also. Because to be very honest, let's be very honest, even if we are there with the child, now in the lockdown also, we are there with the children 24/7. But how much time we actually sit with them and hear, absorb everything that they are saying, right? Because most of the time we are occupied with our phone or with any email, or working parents, they have their own schedule to run. Even the parents who are at home, not they have so many things to run in the house also. So we cannot devote that 100% time to the child. And what time the child needs is 100% child, 100% time where your whole attention is only on the child. So that cannot happen if you are spending 10 hours or 20, 24 hours only with the child at home. That can happen only in a certain period of time. So it's better to take out that time consciously. Because what we do is we are very unmindful of the time we spend with the child. We are very unmindful of the way we are talking to the children most of the time. So we are there with them, but we have a phone in our hand. The child is saying something. Half of our attention is on the phone because we are all multitasking individuals at the end of the day. These days have with the technology and so much happening in our life, it has made us multitasking people. So we are doing 10 things at a time. Probably if someone will be cooking, looking at the phone, and at the same time listening to the concern of the child. So if you're doing three things in one time, so you're giving 30% to all the three tasks that is happening. 30%. So you're giving just 30% attention to your child when the children wants to talk to you something really concerning, really which concerns to them. So it's better, to take out consciously, mindfully, take out some time of your day and where you can give 100% time attention to your child without the phone or without any kind of a multitasking. So this is why the quality and the quantity time, I differentiate between why you should have that.
Thank you for
And
that. Continue.
yes.
I'm so sorry. Sorry for interrupting.
Right. So, and we have to know, what is the aim of this quality time that we are looking at. So, what is the aim? We are doing any activity to, whenever we do any activity, there is always why. Why are we doing that? Right. So, why are we trying to spend that quality time with our children every day? So, this is like, during the development of the child, 0 to 5 years is the very critical phase of the child development where the maximum brain is developed.
And
Right.
then comes the second phase is the adolescent phase. This is what the recent studies are. The second phase is the adolescent phase where children need your full attention because there are so many emotional processes are happening, are developing in the brain. Emotional centers are developing, as well as centers for concentration and memory are also developing at that time. So the
Right.
children need that kind of attention from the parents at this time.
Very true.
So,
So,
yeah.
would you like to suggest something like how to spend quality time with the children? I mean, like,
Okay,
what can
yes.
the parents do regarding this?
Yes, definitely. So the thing is, now when we were talking about the why, so the quality time, basically the aim is to, the outcome of quality time should be that you and your child's bond should become very strong, right? The
Okay.
child knows that my parents are there for me unconditionally. Whatever I do, whatever I have done, and I do something bad at school, I fumble up at school at somewhere, I can go and talk to my parents, without any hesitation, without being scared of that, what my parents will say. They will scold me, they will do this, they will do that. So without the fear, the child should not have a fear of judgment from the parents. The child should not have a fear of being scared of the parent, the idea of being scared of the parents. So the children should be
Right.
very comfortable with the child. So this is the whole aim. The outcome of the quality time is to develop that bond, kind of a bond with your children. So how to develop that bond? So develop that bond is first is like take out some time every day, especially when your children are like in the phase of 0 to 5 years. Be with them every day and do activities which are which both of you like. So I try to suggest people there are 3 R's which they should remember when they are
Okay.
forming the quality time with them. One is the routine. First R is the routine. Second R is the rituals, and third R is the ridiculous. So first the routine is that in your routine, everyday routine, you have to have some time, at least 1 hour with your children every day mapped out in your
Right.
routine also, in your child's routine also. So that is the
Okay.
first R. The second R is the rituals. So how when we start, do not make it a very structured time ki abhi aadha, we have 1 hour, so abhi 10 minute ye karenge, 10 minute ye karenge, 10 minute ye karenge. It should not be like that. It should be like, just let your intuition play the part. Whatever your child is like up to it, start with that. So the ritual would be the start with your quality time rituals should be start with something like, how are your emotions today? Talk to your child, and then your child will ask you, or you tell your child, I'll tell you about my share my emotions today. So I'm feeling very upset, or probably I'm feeling very scared, or I'm feeling very excited about something. So then elaborate on that, why you're feeling scared or happy or excited about something, and then let the children share. So you have to
Right.
share first, because once you start that, the children will start, they will follow the lead. So let and then take it forward. So if your child is probably feeling upset about something or not sure of something, wants to share with you something which happened in the school, talk on that. What happened? Why are you feeling that? How can I help you in that? Why did you try this? Did you try that? So let it just happen, and then do some activities along with that. So if you're feeling probably the child is feeling very upset, so do some activity which lifts the mood of the child. So probably you can do some dancing, or you can let's just dance today, or you like playing something like coloring. If your child is feeling very upset and not able to express, tell the child to color or paint something, because when they're coloring or painting, the emotions come out of the children.
Right,
So or you
right.
can go for a walk, or I mean just be intuitive about it, what your child likes, how your child is able to express himself, and then you'd take forward the time of 1 hour which you have. And the
Right.
third R was the ridiculous. So ridiculous is like, don't be very serious about this thing, right? Ki mujhe ye karna hai, I have to do, it's like a tick mark on the day that I have to-do list,
Right.
you've tick mark one thing. So no, just be very ridiculous, have a lot of fun, make the children laugh a lot. I mean, be silly. I mean, this is what, some children are sometimes like, my mom is so silly. I've heard them talking that she it all talks to me like that. So, just be very silly with the child. Come down to their level. Rather than
Right.
expecting them, to grow up to your level very fast and talk about all the mature stuff, come down to their level. See, where what connects with them most, And it has been observed many times that humor and fun connects, forms the bond very fast with the children.
Right.
So come, have some kind of a humor, get some kind of a, fun activity which is happening. So the children at the end of the day, they do not remember that, how many things we did up with our parents or what was it. They only remember, that day my mom made me laugh so much. We had so much fun. We were laughing. We were rolling over laughing. So they remember those times. They remember those feelings because all our memories, the way they are stored in our brain. So this is the structure of our brain, how our memories are stored. They are stored in the form of feelings, in the form of voices, and in the form of visuals. So feelings are the best thing, the way the memories are stored. So the more you make your child feel loved and child feel connected to you, the child remembers that. Those feelings stay with him. And when you, so, this forms, this is the basis. This is the basis for the strong relation between a parent and a child. So once you are able to lay a good foundation, so, you can be very relaxed that coming years of parenting are going to be very easy for you. So this is the main aim and the main outcome, the goal of the quality time that is there.
Thank you. That was a very nice insight, though I'm not a parent yet. But I have seen my younger sister and brother and everyone that, I have seen my parents the way they react to them. There is a difference the way they used to react with me. And now the younger ones, there is a difference. They're trying to adapt from the surroundings, how to deal and experiences that maybe this way, what, reaction they used to get out of me. That can be different if they approach it differently. So that's just a very general observation which I have made so far, like with parents usually. So that brings us to the next thing, that there are n number of mothers who are working. Even, the kids are very young. So as according to you, you had no help also. And then you felt like, you have to be there for them. So what can you suggest to those parents to manage their work life stress and, the children alone? Because not everyone is, just step on to that. No, I don't want to do anything else. I just want my children. But there are some parents who need it, who want to be a part of everything and their children also. So is there some suggestion you can give according to you?
Definitely, definitely. So there are so many working parents. I mean, both the parents are working. So the first thing is, like, out of your 24 hours in a day, you are spending around 10 to 12 hours in the office doing the work of the office. So if you just spend 1 hour for your child, so this is what I'm asking, just 1 hour in the day for your child, make it according to, what is convenient for you. Make it according to what is convenient for your child also. So, but just 1 hour has to be there because you have to see, the weightage, the relationship that you have with your children. So just giving them 1 hour, nurturing of 1 hour will go a long way. So, and that 1 hour has to be without any kind of, phone, any kind of emails which are happening around, and try to make your mind free in that time. Concentrate it only on the child which is in front of you. So this is just, I think this is the only tip which I can give to parents. Otherwise, 10 hours, you can just see the 10 hours you're devoting in your office on your work. And just 1 hour is like hardly anything. So think about that. And in case it is not possible for one parent to take out that 1 hour of time, 1 hour without, because parents come back quite late and when they are, the child is sleeping or something, then both the parents can have that thing of taking a half an hour in the morning or half an hour. One parent is with the child and half an hour the other parent is with the child, or they can do it on the alternate days. So, 1 hour, if one parent can be, on today, the next day, 1 hour, the other parent can be with the child. But your child needs, it has been scientifically proven, done with so many studies, that the children need at least 1 hour of parenting, unrestricted parenting every day to develop for certain, the areas in the brain are developing. For that complete development, the children need that. and the development of their emotions. They need the, you know, the parents with them at any at in the during the day. So they can have all these kind of permutation combination, either 1 hour or half an hour the parents can split, or alternate day the, they can do it. But the only thing is, during that time, the children are with the parent. Your mind has to be absolutely free of any other concern. Just be concentrated on the child in front of you. And just listen what to the, what the child is saying. You don't have to. And, you know, many a times parents think that quality time means we have to have a structure to it. We need to do, you know, these three, four activities with the child. And I need to probably read or write or tell a story or do that. Nothing. Right. This all is not needed. If you can do that, well and good. But this all is not needed. Just be with the child. Talk to the child. Like how I gave you the example earlier. Talk about how are you feel. How are you feeling today, right? What are your emotions today? Are you feeling upset or are you feeling? Just talk on that. Just talk on that. So this gives, you know, a lot of the emotions of the children are sorted. And when you tell the child about how you are feeling about your day, tell them. But, you know, I had a very rough day in the office. I have a deadline to finish. So after talking to you, Mama will just go and, you know, start finishing her work. And probably it'll take me, you know, tell them about your troubles. Whatever is troubling you, just share with them honestly. So when the children know that, you know, you're honestly sharing, the children will also start sharing with you honestly. They sense that. They are very good at sensing that when they are being taken for a ride and when the parent is being honest to them. So, you know, just be there with them. That is the only thing. Just be there for the child. And, you know, the 3 hours have any one kind of a ritual. So if the mother is there with the child every day, the mother will do this particular thing with the children every day. Or if the father is there, father will do this one particular thing with the child every day. And then some kind element of fun should be there in any way. Yeah, tell me about a joke, or let's just, you know, sit and watch a movie. Let's just sit and watch a fun movie. So just sitting with your child, you know, just hug your child in your lap and just sit or watch a movie with your child. Or if your child is a teenager, just, you know, sit with your child there, have a, some snacks and just sit and watch a TV. But that is also, you know, quality time. That can also be considered as a quality time, but not every day. Yes, of course, not every day. Some days when you're very tired, not in a framework, you know, frame of mind to talk. And you can just relax with your children because they also love the similar activity. You are sitting with them, enjoying a similar activity. So that is also kind of a quality time.
Right.
Right. So these, there are so many different ways in which number we can do. And yes, for, you know, though they don't have to be a structure. So do not get bogged down by the working parents, especially don't get bogged down. Yeah, I have to do this, do that. Just go by your intuition and what your child likes. Yeah. So, you know, that is the best you can do.
Definitely. Because you have kind of answered the next two questions of mine. Because I was about to ask you that, you know, like, according to you, do you think that spending quality time would be only, you know, playing with the children or doing some activities? Can it not include a proper conversation sometimes? That's what you answered already. So, let me bring you to another question, which is that, how do you think that, you know, we can strike a quality conversation with the child? You know, starting a conversation is maybe something what a younger one is not looking forward to. All of a sudden, they are looking forward to have fun. And it's a very hard task to, you know, sit with the child and talk and maybe some take get something out of the child. Now you tell me, what do you have with you? So what do you suggest that, you know, things can, as you said, that be honest with the child. And if you share your things, the children will also share theirs. But that's what it is. That's what, you know, parents think that what we have or what we face are something the adults needs to talk, not not with the child. So what do you suggest? What kind of conversations, you know, striking conversation, which can be a part of a quality time spending with your child can be?
Right. So first you are told that if you want to get something out of the child. So that is, you know, that is a very tricky thing because children are not, they are ready to talk on their own time. They need that kind of comfort to develop. that they need that kind of, they need their own mood and comfort and the trust with the parent to open up about something, whatever has happened in their school or with their friends. So right. for if you want, you're specifically looking for your child to tell you something, you have to wait. So, you have to wait, be open with the child, tell them, that this is, I'm listening. Whenever you're ready, let me know. I will be, I will listen to you. And whenever okay. the child comes to you and the child wants to tell you something, stop everything. So many a times it happens that, children are ready to talk to you. They have built up yes. the courage and they're ready and come and tell you something and you're busy doing something else. So, right. you tell them, 2 minutes, Rukjo, I'll talk to you later. I don't have time right now. Yes. So the window is closed forever, right? So then the children will not be able to, muster up the courage and come and tell you. So just tell them, sit with me here. Instead of, you cannot leave the thing. Probably you're on a call with someone else. Just tell them, come and, sit with me here. Just hold their hand or just let them be there with you. And just give me 2 minutes, just say very politely and just sit here with me for 2 minutes, hold their hand and just, keep them sitting so that they know that they have formed a connection with you.
Right.
And then just finish off your call, whatever work you're doing, just finish it off and then give your 100% attention. So this is when if you want to get something out of the child. So whenever they are ready, you need to be there for them. Next, you said how to have a very good quality conversation with the child. Right. So this is when the children are young. So when the children are very young, so definitely it depends that, you want to probably tell them about something,
right.
about any of the qualities, or you want to impart them any quality or tell them any learning. So they will not listen to you whenever you're telling them something.
Right.
So the best thing is if you want to teach them something, be it a value of being truthful or being a value of being very honest, so just do it. Whenever you do something, they will follow you. So, that is there. Otherwise, if you're talking to the children, if you really want to have tell your children about something, go down to their level. Go, talk to them that, this is what, and give them start with a story or start mm-hmm. with an example of someone or your own story that when I was young, your grandmother told me this. And I was, my God, I was so shocked when I heard that. What do you think would have happened? Have some kind of a storytelling expressions. You can make up the story also. It doesn't have to be something that actually happened, you faced. But right. since you're trying to talk to the child about something, go to that level. Go in that their frame of mind. Be in that what they would
so
be
that
thinking at that
they
time.
Can relate. So
they
that they
can relate to you. Yes, the whole idea is making them relate to you so that and form that bond, the trust with you so
right.
that they can talk to you later
right.
on. So this is probably, you can sit and talk with your child and with your teenagers, if your child is a teenager. So with the teenager, it is like, the same thing that now if you have for over the years, like, for 13, 14 years, you've not spoken to your child. And then suddenly one day you want to know what your teenager is up to. And you sit in front of the child and say, when I was doing this, I felt very bad. I felt, start telling about yourself when you immediately you expect your child to come out with their problems. That is not going to happen. So you have to earn the trust. You really have to earn their trust back. So it will take time, slowly, slowly talk to them every day about something that I am there in your gestures, make them realize that, you are really there for them. Do not cut off the children at every small thing. If they started telling you something that, I did, if this thing happened, and don't say, I told you not to do this. Every
right.
time I tell you, still you fall into problem. Still you do that. So, the more you restrain yourself from correcting your children at, every step, the more you refrain yourself from, condemning them at every step, the more right. your bond will be formed. So nobody right. likes, even, what about children, even adults, if as an adult, if we are snapping at someone and telling, ye galat kar diya, tumne ye galat kar diya, tumhe ye nahi aata. So
right.
the person will, start keeping a distance from us, not coming and talking to you. So same logic we have to apply with our children. So if you want them to talk to you, so just build that trust around them first.
Right, because
So,
this is
yeah.
what you have explained right now regarding the teenager ones. So in as we go, like you maybe 10, 20 years back, and that time this culture was not there too much around that, you know, the parents are going to talk to their children all the time, or maybe, you know, build up conversations and be a part of
Absolutely.
and know what they want. They were like a little bossy, I would say, as a parent.
Yes. That's right.
So now.
Absolutely.
Now these parents sometimes they, you know, face issues with their teenagers or maybe their adults also because they are not
Yes.
able to relate or connect with them on that level the way now the parents are connecting with their children. So
Yes, absolutely.
and waiting for a maybe very long time to for the children to come around would be not, you know, according to the scenarios,
Yes.
is not convenient enough. So what do
Yes.
you suggest, like even being a child? Being a child, there must be some children, you know, some parents who are still facing the same problem with their parents. And if you could suggest something to them, how they can initiate that now on that, you know, be able to share things with their parents. Because whether you are a 2-year-old or whether you are a 32-year-old, that does not really make a difference. Because then again, you have a parent and child relation.
Same, yes, the equation is the same. The parent and child equation remains the same,
Yeah,
whatever your age is, and whatever
right.
the age of your parent is. So now, as you said, if probably if you're a older adult, a
Yeah.
younger adult, I would say, if you're a younger adult and you are your parents have not been, because what happened is, when probably let me take my example. When I was growing up, all this thing wasn't there. Right, there was
Right.
no social media. There was no, this. I was not. I mean, we were not exposed to so much of
Yeah.
information which the children have these days, right?
True.
And same way, our parents also, they learned their way of parenting was what was passed on from generations, right?
Yeah.
So they were not wrong. They were doing the best they could do from their in their ability, but their parenting was passed down from generations, and they were not aware of what all things can go wrong, what are the how they are how their behavior is impacting the emotions of the child and the emotional development, the mental development of the child. So they were these all things were not available available to them. Now, why it is happening, why the thing is, shift is happening is because of so much of this social media advancement, so much of technology advancement, things are bombarded at us. So children know that, now I have someone, a small child who, Googled up what is a toxic parent, and she sends it to her mother, you are a toxic parent, Rumi. So this is
Okay.
what the children are. The children are so smart these days. They are very
Right.
smart. So to come up to their level, the parents are also changing there. So we
Yeah.
have to change as the new age parents. Now these we parents, we have to change our parenting style because we have to parent a very smart generation. So these children are already 2 steps ahead of us. They know everything about technology. They know everything what is
Right.
happening around. So to manage themselves emotionally and mentally well, we have to step up at some places. So we cannot be that authoritarian type of a parent who's telling them, do this, do that, whatever,
Right.
my way or the highway kind of a parent. Because then,
Right.
the children are very
Fragile.
aware and yes,
Right.
aware and very fragile that, this is what will happen to me. This is what will
Right.
happen to me. The children read up so many things, right?
Right.
So
Right.
this is why the new age parents have to shift their way of parenting, and this is the new way of the conscious or the mindful parenting way, what
Right.
we are talking about. I normally talk about. So how can we, so now your question was like, how can we manage the parent-child relationship
Yeah.
in the older parents, right? How it had happened.
Because then
So
they
the same
compare.
way,
Because then they compare that हमने तो ऐसे
yes,
किया था, तुम तो हो गए
हमने
बड़े,
ऐसे
यू
किया
नो,
था. हाँ, yes, सब वही
दैट्स
बोलते हैं कि
चेंजिंग.
मैंने, this is what happens between so many couples, that they say, I was raised this way, I turned out very well, right?
Yeah.
And the other couple will say, the spouse will say, see, I was raised this way, I turned out very well. So
Yeah.
they have a conflict in parenting. So just to tell your parent, I mean, tell the parents, it's like the elders, is basically make them aware of the situation that number A, the environment has changed around us. The environment, what was there around 40 years back, is totally changed. The environment has changed. The number two, the mentality of the people have changed around it. So in that time, you know, around 40 years back, or, you know, probably when we were growing up, there was hardly any, you know, the children used to play out in the parks till sunset. You know, they used to be playing out, and then they used to come home, and the parents were not worried ki bachcha kahan pe khel raha hai. Now, you know, if the child is like late, another just 10 minutes late from coming from school, the parents are like, you know, where has the child gone? Because the environment has become so bad.
Right.
The society has changed in so many ways that we are very overprotective about the children also. So whatever was, you know, happening in their time has changed in this
generation. To a certain
generation.
Level. Right.
Yes, to a certain level, it has changed to a lot. And the same way, how the children behaved in that time. So they listened to whatever their parents said without arguing, or probably in some cases, yes, they were arguing, and that those children were termed as rebellious children.
Right.
Right. So there was some, but most of the, you know, children, they used to listen to what their parents are saying.
Right.
But now the generation is like that. They do not say, they ask you upfront, why are you telling me that? You know, why
right.
should I do that? So they have so many questions. So you have to answer the questions of the child to, you know, for their curiosity to come get down. You have to tell them that why you should follow what I'm doing. It's not just this is the thing. It is there is a reason behind it. You have to reason
right.
out everything with your children so that they understand. And now if you see the result of the parenting, which has happened around 40 years back. So now if you see the adults who are probably are somewhere around 35 to 40 year of age, they are
right.
all, you know, they are, they have, most of them have hit a midlife crisis. There is
right.
something we called a midlife crisis.
Midlife.
Why the midlife crisis is happening? Midlife crisis is happening because whatever, you know, a child who wanted to grow up to be a musician was forced to become an engineer by the parents, right? So now the child became a parent, got a job, did a degree, got a job, did everything. And now there's still some hollowness. The child is still searching for something. And suddenly one point comes when they drop everything, that now the adult, they drop everything and they go back to the music.
Right.
So this is what is the midlife crisis, which many people are seeing around. So we are not happy with what we are doing because we wanted to do something else.
Right.
And we were not allowed to do it by our parents. So now when we have a chance, we are doing it on our own.
Right.
So, you know, this is what. So now if with the children these days, if you're probably your son or a daughter, they just want to be an artist or just, you know, a doodle artist. So encourage them, theek hai, be a doodle artist, but be the very, very best in that. So that, you know,
right.
nobody else is like, you have a standing in the society.
Right.
Do that. Go for it if you want to do. Instead of telling them ki nahi yahi karna hai, doctor banna hai, doctor hi bano ya engineer hi bano. So that after 10 years or something, the child leaves everything, whatever the child, and then they pursue something else.
Yeah.
So this is where the whole shift is happening. And this is where we have to, the mindful parenting talks a lot about managing the emotions of the children.
Right.
Because in earlier times, we were not told how to manage our emotions. We were always
right.
told ki apne emotions chupa ke rakhna hai. Kisi ke samne rona nahi hai. Ladke to ro hi nahi sakte hai. Right? This is
right.
what is going on in our society. So, kya hans rahe ho zyada jo bahar ladkiyon ko bahar jaake zor se nahi hasna. Aapko ye nahi karna hai. Kisi ke samne gusse se chillana nahi hai. We were just
yeah.
told to suppress our emotions. So, suppressing our emotions for a long time has, you know, affected a lot of people. This is where it is also leading up to the midlife crisis, which is coming. So there are a lot
right.
of things. You know, there are a lot of things. So I'm just going off the topic, just talking about it.
No, you're actually not.
But,
because what you are telling right now, if there are parents listening to us at the moment, they will understand what, you know, what they will recall. What were the things
what
they were trying to revolt
that,
against? There are,
right.
you know, what I feel is like, there are two words, introvert and extrovert.
Extrovert.
So I've always
right.
told my parents that introvert and extrovert comes from the home. So
yeah.
When,
yeah.
you know,
Absolutely.
When you conversate with your child, when you're talking to them, it's easy for them to talk outside. But if you
right.
don't talk to them, it becomes very,
Suppressive.
You know, very uncomfortable for the child to talk outside the
outside.
Comfort zone. Because that
Absolutely, very right.
comfort zone is not coming with the
Very
parents
right.
also.
Very right. Very
Many
right.
a times I found that kids are very
Absolutely.
comfortable talking to the teacher, right?
Yes.
I will not tell mamma because then mamma will say that don't think like that or don't say like that. Because
I
the parents are
absolutely agree.
scared.
Yes.
They're very scared most of the time of talking about all of this. So
Yes.
that includes a very important question which I want to ask you that in this quality time with the children, as you mentioned that conversations can be a part of it, not playing is all important, but how the world is working, you know, how the world works, what are the things happening in the world, and you know, telling them about or explaining them about, giving them awareness about things which are happening in the world. Can this be a part of the quality time conversation with the children?
Absolutely, absolutely. Why not? Why not? So, you know, every day you cannot be just sitting and talking to the children. So,
Right.
this is what by the routine I meant that routine and rituals on the 3 hours, the routine and rituals was like one day you can keep for something, we'll take up a social topic.
Right.
Okay. And then it is your duty, probably, Discovery has, I think BBC or Discovery, they have a lot of topics which they have documentaries made on all the topics. So probably you can
Okay.
just sit with the child and watch that. And then
Okay.
after that, wherever you feel, you can just pause and ask, what do you think about it? This is my thought, which is about it. So
Right.
ask what the child has absorbed, ask what the way the child has absorbed. So ask
Right.
them and, have a discussion around it. So probably you can have the other parent also or the other sibling, whoever is there in the family. So
Right,
you can all
right.
sit, whenever you're having your dinner together. So this is one thing, everybody should have their dinner together at one table. And there you are talking about certain subjects. So just pick up that topic is that, today we saw that, and this is what we saw, and this is what my little one thought about it. So, just
Right.
encourage the ch children to talk. And
Right.
whenever the children tell you anything, whether their perspective is right or wrong, just encourage the child. Do not say that, you cannot understand, tumhe to kuch samajh hi nahi aata hai.
Right.
Whatever, this is what the person was trying to say, and this is what you understood. Do
Right.
not, put the child down. Just say that, wow, this is another perspective. I never thought about it. So
Yeah.
let's talk about it again, right? So the child will be interested. And then tell about your perspective. What actually was the thinking? Tell about yours. This is what I feel should be there. So what do you think about it? So, try to have a conversation with the child. So every
Right.
day you can have a different thing with, you're doing a different thing with the child. One day you
True.
can, there are so many board games these days. Board games based on so many social issues. So, if you
Right.
want to teach your child about a financial, how to manage their finances or how to be more financially independent, you can play Monopoly with them and, tell them
Right.
how to use that money, how to, there is bank in the money. So, you can tell them and talking about the bank, whenever you next time you go to the bank, show them this is the checkbook, this is that. So
Right.
take everything. I mean, it doesn't have to be the same thing. Every day has to be a different agenda,
Right.
basically.
Right.
So, but not very structured. Don't stress yourself around
Yeah.
it. But yes, every day has to be something different. Bring up a social issue, bring up a value, talk about, if you want to tell them about truth, tell them stories about Gandhiji or, Abdul Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam, how they did in their life, and this is how they were doing as children. So bring up all these topics. I mean, and one day
Right.
is a very, this is what I tell people, one day is a very good day when you're doing in a week to talk to them about some personality, they should
Right.
look up.
Right.
And some personality who is like really like Gandhiji ho gaye, yeah, Abraham Lincoln or Abdul Kalam ji or so many other people are there.
Right.
So you want to your child to look up to so that the children absorb the qualities of the people. So every day has to be different. And
Right.
this is how probably we can talk. And talking how to make them talk is probably just show them something first. There can be a content if it is a difficult subject that you're trying to pick up. So probably if you want to tell them about about their sexuality and all this good touch, bad touch. So there are so much content which is made for children, cartoon content which is made for children.
Yes,
So
there
show
is.
them that according depending upon the age of your child, show them that stuff and then talk about it. So you can do so many things with the children
Right.
that way.
So that Now let's talk about a little bit about the online schooling and your aspects. Like, what do you feel? My question is, like, are the parents, do you feel that the parents are facing more of stress during this pandemic of, or maybe the online preschooling, or is it a very good thing for the parent to be able to get connected and not looking towards it as a, you know, stress developing something which is sparking it up a lot? Because we understand, like, in today's day, there are a lot of things which, you know, create a lot of stress for the parents.
Right.
Maybe it's outside, maybe it's family, maybe it's food. Even food is a big stress topic. What to make? Yeah. Now that Kuchachhava now is a very...
Or healthy South mein.
Yeah, now that's a very dangerous thing, because I have seen mothers getting worried, my child does not eat anything. But now it's like, I feel that being at home, is it actually developing more of stress or giving them time to understand their children and family more, or being able to balance everything? What do you think according to it? And how is Learning Pi being a great, you know, platform for all of this online preschooling and the growth of the child?
Right. So, okay. So let me start with the stress thing, right? The stress is definitely, when the pandemic started, everybody was like, wow, you know, it was like an extended vacation. We got a, you know, extended weekend hota hai, extended vacation ho gaya. Everybody was enjoying it. But the moment it started lingering on, and with the uncertainty, and with so much of, you know, unknown things happening around us, the stress started building up. And the stress of, you know, every day, you know, everybody in the family, the children, the parents, the working parents, or the parents at home, everybody, they had their own ways of releasing that stress. The children used to go to school, play out with their friends, play in the park or anything. Their stress was released. The parents, you know, who are in the office, going out, meeting their friends, be with the office and all, their stress was released. The working mother, you know, probably you can go for shopping or just meet up with a friend or somebody, your stress was released. Now they are not able to release their stress. And now the stress is building up, building up. So the stress is lot. Yes, the stress is lot in the parents also, and in the children also. And somewhere now it is spilling over. The people are, you know, everybody is showing the results of the stress. It is happening. And in the stress, we do remember ki hum bachche pe nahi chillayenge. But sometimes, you know, if you have something to urgent to attend to, and your child is also there, and some house workers also there, you do lose it. And you do, you know, shout at everyone around you. So the stress is definitely building up. It is happening. Now, stress of the online learning. So stress of the online learning and preschool, you mentioned specifically. So preschool mein, yes, you know, it is the duty of the parents to make your children be able to sit at a place for a certain amount of time.
Right.
And how the Learning Pi is different from other schooling the other preschool which is happening is, the content which you, I have seen, is very child-centric. Okay.
Right.
So all the children, like, they have three basic modes of learning. One is a visual mode, one is an auditory mode, and the other is a feeling mode, right? So some children, they learn by just looking at the things, okay?
Right.
And they absorb so much. Some children, they hear things and then they absorb so much. And some children are like, you know, the way they felt, the whole thing, the experience made them feel. So they feel, they learn that way.
Right.
So the content which is being shown, which I've seen your content, is I think it has all the three qualities, because it's visually so appealing to the children. So they are hooked, because, you know, these are the primary colors with the children are like, you know, they affect the learning centers of the brain, the memory centers of the brain. So the children are hooked. And those who are like visual learners are like absolutely glued to the thing. Then the way the content comes, the music content comes, the voice modulation, everything comes. So those who are the, you know, auditory learners, so they also have something to be there. And the way the whole thing is packaged, right? The stories are told, everything is happening. And the way the emotions are also brought up in your content. So that way, the children who are the kinesthetic learners, they are also like glued to the whole content. So how it differs from what is happening with the school, online learning, preschooling at the school.
Right.
There, one teacher is sitting in front of the school. You know, most of the time, the screen is occupied by one teacher and she's saying something. So how long can one teacher engage the attention of a child? So, you know, they do show in between or they do, have some activities. But, you know, the parents, because the children are very small in preschool, so their parents have to come and help them in doing the activities. So I have a lot of mothers who are like, you know, ki uska 3 ghante ka school hota hai, mujhe saath mein I have to sit there for 3 hours. So, you know, the 3 hours of my time is days wasted because I have to sit there. Why? Because there are so many activities the teacher is trying to do when the school is going on, and which the child need help because they're very young. They cannot have that coordination. So they need help. So this is why the stress of, learning on the parent is coming in the preschool children, basically, because they are like, yeah, I have my work to do and I have to sit with my child also to help him do the work that the teacher is saying. And if there are some projects which are given, so the children are not able to make. I mean, be honest, let's be honest, that it is the parents who make most of the projects for the, preschool children, unless the child goes to the school and the teachers help them.
Right.
So, that is why the stress of the parents are coming. And this is how, your platform is like, you can leave it open for the child and the parent can do other thing because it is learning, it is going on and the child is totally engaged in that.
Right.
And the best part is that, you know, unko bada achha lagta hai ki phone pe jab aisa kuch aa raha hai.
Right.
Phone pe agar now, like now, you know, like I'm talking, so the I cannot hold, we both are there having a conversation. We both cannot hold the attention of the parents for so long. They're coming and leaving and going. Right.
Right.
So how do you expect that a very small child who doesn't know why he's sitting in front of the phone and, you know, listening to the teacher in front of him, who he has never met in his life. You know, so many children have started, very unfortunate, but many children have started schooling only with the screen.
Right.
So they don't have the whole concept of it. So this is the way. So this is, I think, the content that you are making is like, because it engages the child visually, auditory, and in the kinesthetic learning. It helps the child in that way. So the child is actually totally glued. So I think for preschoolers, this is the perfect thing which should be probably available to the children for learning.
Right. I'm very glad that you mentioned that thing with the parents, because I think now even, you know, the others can relate to it, because looking at the videos nowadays, like obviously a teacher sitting at home who has been teaching like all her life in a school with all the props, you know, at a distance of her hand. And then all of a sudden she has to sit on a chair and a table and in front of a screen, learn so many new, you know, how to use the gadgets and everything. And then teach along with it.
Teach along with
Very
it.
Very slowly they were able to, you know, get a hold of smart boards, right? Nowadays, boards, everywhere we have that. Now they had to get a hold of laptops and their phones.
And
the
Zoom.
Children, and Zoom. And the children are so fond of looking at colorful things. So coming up
absolutely.
With the learning pie idea and becoming a part of it was a complete new journey. It was a complete new thing, right? Because, you know, like, how long am I going to watch someone speaking
absolutely.
On the screen?
Absolutely.
It's very hard. And then when you see that the minute she speaks, there's something popping on the screen.
Right.
Now that's exciting. Right. Now what is she going to speak next? That is developing a lot of curiosity.
Yes, yes.
And the mother does not need to show, ki, this is glue. Please hold this in your hand. This is how you're going to turn it. When the teacher is already doing that, the thing
doing
is happening
that.
In front of the child, whether happening. The child is fast or slow, that does not really matter. Because you have the whole day to finish it, right? You can finish it whenever.
Right.
And more than 5 to 7 minutes, a child would never do that activity.
Never do that.
If the child wants to do it, I think the child will be able to finish it up. When in like maybe sooner than the teacher is doing it. Because that's what they enjoy they are going to do. And parents stressing out for that, when the schools are going to open, when the schools are going to open. I think, as you said, that spending time with the child and even, I'm not saying about the cases the parents who are working, but I'm saying about the parents who are home and they have certain work to do. And this pandemic has opened the doors for them. Right, to be
Right.
able to spend time with their children.
Fine.
And now
Yeah.
Learning Pie is actually the icing that, you know, they can still work and their child can still be engaged in learning.
Right.
So there are
Right.
many
Even for
ideas.
the working parents, I think even for the working parents, it's a very good thing that, you know,
Yeah.
if they are going to office or probably they're working from home, still they
Right.
know that the child is very meaningfully engaged. You know, if you are with a platform like Learning Pie, the child is very meaningfully engaged.
Right.
So probably it's for the working parents as well,
And
not
we
only
have
for
made
the.
it very comfortable for them. Like, even if they are not able to attend the class, they
Right.
are going in the recorded sessions. So you
Recorded
can play
sessions.
them, pause them, whatever you want to do according to your
That is
child
the
and your
best thing. That
convenience.
is the best thing. So that when you know when the parent have time. So probably you know the what happens with the school is the schools have a time like you know 8 to 10 or something like that.
Right,
They're there in the
right.
morning, and that is the time when many parents are busy with their own thing. So now if they have the facility of watching, अच्छा ठीक है, I missed it in the morning. Probably I'll watch it when at 4 o'clock when I'm free. I will watch it at that time, and I will make my child sit along with me. So
Right.
that quality time can be, you know, have include some time of this activity also, which was
Right.
happening. So
Right.
that is why it's the most very convenient. And this is the difference between the regular schooling because they do not have any recordings. They are
Right.
not sending any recordings and the Learning Pie, which is happening.
Yeah, like I think that sending the box also made everything easier because the parent doesn't have to search for things to be
Search for
able to
everything.
engage the child with
Absolutely.
anything.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So the idea is being followed by many companies, but what I feel is like it's a proper routine thing which we are working
Yes.
on, starting from,
Yes.
you know, like doing a prayer to ending on saying a goodbye as we do in schools.
Absolutely.
It's just
Absolutely.
that the child is not standing in a prayer line to do the prayer and not
To do the
sitting on the
prayer.
chair with 25 children inside the class. Yeah,
Yes.
that's the only
Yes.
difference which is there.
That is
But
the difference. And
yeah.
that, yes, everybody is. Yes,
And
everybody is
attending
used
these
to it that.
classes, do you think attending these classes can be a part of quality time?
It can be, yes. That's what I said, you know, that like in your quality time, you can, because if the parent, the children missed something, they were not able
Right.
to do some activity, and but they really like to do that. So they in the quality time, the parent can always have that, you know, this is the time when I'm free with my child. So let's do it this way. So, you know, it's
Right.
not going to take the whole 1 hour. So just a part of the time. So let's have this thing. And this is a fun activity for the children. Anything
Right.
creative is fun. Anything
Right.
creating creative is always fun for the children because they are able to make something, do something with their hands. So that, you know, their eye and hand coordination is increasing. So they
Right.
can do something, and which is and at the end of it, when they are actually they know that you know they're making something, they are onto something. It's quite exciting. So
Right.
that can definitely be a part of the quality time for the children.
Okay. That was a lot to take in at once because, believe me, a person who writes a book and when you start talking to that person, they have a lot to share.
It
So,
just flows off, so
yeah, because that's the best thing. Anything you ask and anything which is, you know, like not letting you step forward and you ask a person who has so much knowledge and learned so far looking at others and experiencing all of it, gives you the answer in detail at once. And then you're able to like, yes, it was right in front of me, but the guidance just, you know, opened it for me. So thank you so much. It was great having you here with all of your insight regarding the quality time and, you know, managing the stress, which is at the moment a very big thing for everyone. And I suppose in every house, because
Yes,
whether the
yes.
child is 2 years, 3 years, 4 years or 20 years, I think they are facing it
Absolutely. It is
everywhere.
there.
And these
Yes.
suggestions are not, you know, something which can be implemented on only a 2-year-old, but can be implemented anywhere else.
Anywhere.
So
Absolutely.
thank you so much
Absolutely.
for, you know, joining us here today, doctor. And I'll call you a doctor because I think my tooth is aching, I suppose. But I recall you mentioned that you are a child specialist. So don't worry. I'll suggest to the children that she's the right person to go to.
Yes.
So thank you so much. And we are actually kind of now reading and, you know, like having a great encounter with you. I believe that you have a lot to do. A lot of parents need you out there. And I hope that through our medium also, you have a lot of people around and you get a lot of knowledge to share with everyone.
Thank you.
I'll be glad and, mention people that I actually had a great conversation with an award-winning person regarding a parenting session, which I might, suggest to the parents, not me, but yeah. Thank you so much. And I hope you enjoyed your time with us.
Thank you so much. It was a wonderful, conversation we had. And the questions which you actually asked were like really insightful. So I'm sure the parents would have helped with, would have benefited from all that. And one thing probably if Learning Pie can be concentrate more on emotions, dealing with emotions in the children. That is one thing, which the children really need. This is the need of the hour, as we can say.
Right.
This is the need of the hour. So start dealing, if you can have your content towards the emotions of the, concentrating on the emotions of the children. Teaching them what emotions are, basically.
How to express themselves can be a part of it.
Yes. How to express themselves. So basically, why a child, if I'll just probably, are we over time? We have overshot the time.
We can push it a little bit. Don't worry.
I have smaller children. So a child is probably, parents say that my child is always crying. So why the child is always crying? Because a child who is very small doesn't know that, I'm hungry, so I need to ask for food. Or doesn't know that, it's hurting me somewhere and I need to tell my parent. Doesn't know that probably, I'm feeling upset about something. Then I need to react in a certain way. So whatever discomfort they have, they just cry. So, telling children that, this is what happens when you are sad. And showing them, and this is how we tell someone that we are feeling sad. Or this is what happens when we are scared. And telling someone that, how we are scared. So giving them words, giving them, basically introducing them to the emotions is what I mean. Introducing them to certain emotions and just expressing it. Just expressing it. So that the parent around should know that, okay, my child is feeling that.
Right.
So
as we were planning to have emotions concept later, now we are going to have it sooner so that we can keep discussing it. And I totally agree with you that we need, I suppose that teachers are the first thing the child meets when they start going to a school.
Yes.
And they are the ones who teach them how to go home and tell their parents everything, right?
Absolutely.
So I agree with that. And we'll make sure to, put it up in the whole curriculum that how to express themselves is very important.
Wonderful.
And I agree with you.
Wonderful.
And thank you once again for joining us here today.
Right.
And we had a
great session.
And I hope these parents whoever was here and will be watching these videos further in future will have a great insight to all the answers to their questions.
Right. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It was a lovely conversation.
Same here.
People can follow me on my Instagram, which is, mentioned. So they can, whoever wants to follow me, they can get in touch with me there.
Yeah. Her name is Dr. Mona Gujral.
Mona Gujral. Right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Harshita. Lovely meeting you.
Same here.
Bye-bye.
Same here. Bye-bye.